That was the opening of Henry Dumont's Latin motet, Media Vita, sung by Duke Vespers Ensemble in a service recorded last year. The service of Vespers takes place in a darkened Duke chapel, with the singers assembled under the Flentrop organ at the rear of the building, singing by candlelight. As we've just heard, the motet begins with all the voices in the lower part of their ranges, creating a dark and rather brooding effect. The words are somber too, opening with, "In the midst of life, we are in death." The text of Media Vita had become popular in Dumont's time and place, 17th century Western Europe, which was suffering from repeated outbreaks of the plague. It was used in many liturgies during Lent and at funerals, and it was also sung as a hymn to ask for God's aid in time of public need. In this way, the music can speak quite powerfully to us now, in our time of public need, and as we move from Lent through Holy Week. Dumont's setting was published in 1668, and it shows his familiarity with Italian music, with its evocative word painting and effective use of dissonances. After the somber start, the texture breaks into smaller groupings for the words, "To whom shall we cry for help but thee, O Lord?" with the anxiety illustrated by syncopated entries and faster rhythms. The text of the motet includes an adaptation of the words of the Trisagion, the threefold acclamation commonly sung on Good Friday. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and merciful Saviour. These three powerful invocations are composed with a strong harmonic drive and lead to an effective and affecting use of chromaticism to illustrate the bitter pains of death. As if to allow these ideas to sink in, Dumont then repeats the second half of the piece. Dumont's life may seem quite distant to us today. He was born in 1610 in the Netherlands, and he and his brother received their musical education as boy choristers at the Basilica in Maastricht. In 1639, Henri moved to Paris to serve as the organist at the parish church of Saint-Paul. and in 1663 he became music director at the Royal Chapel in Versailles. In 1673 he was appointed master of the Queen's music. And yet, from this royal position more than three centuries ago, we can hear in his composition a longing and a prayer that are very relevant for us today. As we move through Holy Week in our current strange, socially distant and disrupted world, Dumont's beautiful music provides an opportunity to reflect on Christ's passion and prepare for the joy of Easter.